just pay to hold your own studies and stay. You must find something.
Sister, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Welcome.
Oh. Happy Sunday.
I wish you.
How was service today?
Fine. As I was saying, we need to.
Actually, we just want to use this opportunity to invite you to this
our program that is coming. So you can.
Thank you. I've seen it. There's no need of taking it.
Thank you.
No, you can take it. This one is going to come. We need to take our therapy. Just give us like a few minutes of your time so that we can.
They can see we are very busy. Maybe that should be next some other time.
Auntie, we will not take much of your time. Just for
as you can see, you are not blind. We are busy doing something. So
okay. But you see, within the GP, we are done.
I said we are busy. I'm not interested to hear whatsoever you want to say. I said next time. Huh?
See you next time.
So I know what you
do. Excuse me, Vera. Good afternoon.
Good
afternoon. How are you? Yeah. How is your day going? Actually, brother, we are on evangelism. I want to invite you to this our church program.
As you can see, I'm going to church, but I'm not physically fit. I'm going to take my ticket.
Oh,
thank you.
Brother, we'll not take much time from you now. Just 5 minutes.
We are just okay, if you are not very strong, why not just come and sit down here and see that?
Continue, 2 minutes.
Okay, alright. Bless you, brother. Brother, see, what we are about to tell you now is that God loves you.
Thank God.
See, God loves you so much that He gave His only begotten Son to die for you.
Yes.
See, this God we are talking about is a God that can turn your situation around.
Yes, can turn it around at any time.
He can turn it around. See, the only thing you need to do is just say, God, come into my life. And if you do that, you will not regret it. Our God is merciful. He can help you. He has helped so many people.
Yes.
And today also, He's ready to help you. I don't know if my sister has anything to say, just to add one to this.
I don't have much to say than to tell you that my brother is saying, look at us. He loves us so much. He has
so
been
there. He's over an hour now.
He's so excellent. He's so marvelous. Jesus, I love you. Jesus is so sweet. See, let me just show you a place in the Bible to confirm the word of God. This is Jesus speaking to us here. Let's open our Bible to the book of John chapter 15. John 15. John chapter 15.
So you are going to Matthew.
I've seen it.
John chapter 15 verse 7 said, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what you will and it shall be done unto you. Brother, you see, this is the word of God for you. Jesus said, if you abide in him, in fact, everything will be prosperous for you.
Exactly.
I don't know if my brother have anything, just to summarize it all.
Let me just summarize everything See, to round up all the statements, everything that you have been saying from the beginning, everything we are telling you today is that our God is a merciful God.
Oh, yes.
See, look our at God is calling you. Just like the prodigal son,
today
should come out to me. No matter
for the past 2 hours now, they are
when you come out to him.
So what are they
God
preaching
is
about?
Going to embrace you.
Yes!
Just like the father embraced the prodigal son. He's going to embrace you.
Once again.
So, I don't know, my sister can just lead you to the word of prayer so that we can just.
Wait,
brother,
before I pray for
you.
In the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 3. There's no need of opening there. Chapter 3, verse 1. The Bible wants us to understand there is a season and a time for
everything
that is ahead and under heaven. He said he will come as a thief in the night. When no man will know the time, it's very short. So read out to him. I don't know, my brother, just round it up.
So let me just round up everything you have been saying since morning.
Yes, yes.
Explain what she just said. See, what she said is that